Hey guys, Jason with Bintelli Scooters, and today we're going to go over a valve adjustment on this 49cc Bintelli Sprint. And it's worth mentioning that we always require all of our end users to have this done before the first 500 miles. It's a very, very important aspect of the maintenance that must be done in order to honor the warranty and make sure that you have the longest service life possible out of the engine. If you don't own a Bintelli, hopefully this video serves as a good guide for you so you'll be able to do it on your own. Without further ado, let's get to it. Now, in order to do this valve adjustment on this 49cc scooter, we're going to have to gain access to the engine, which is underneath these plastics right here. Every scooter is a little bit different, but for the most part, you're always going to have to remove the seat and possibly some of these front plastics as well. If you have any questions about your particular model, I would check out the internet to see if there's any helpful guides, but for the most part, it's pretty straightforward. Simply remove the seat using usually 10 millimeter bolts, possibly some Phillips screws, and any of your side plastics are usually just Phillips screws. It's very easy to do. Just take your time and make sure you don't damage any of the plastics. All right, and as you can see, we went ahead, we removed the seat bucket here and this front plastic shroud, which gives us a really good shot here to the head. We want to make sure that we can get tools in here to access all these 8 millimeter bolts that are going around the valve cover, because we have to remove this piece in order to gain access to the valves. All right, so in order to gain access to the valves, we're going to need to remove this valve cover that you see here. In order to do so, you're going to have to remove a couple of these 8 millimeter bolts. Typically, you'll have four of these that are a certain size, they're actually a little bit longer, and you'll have two more on this valve down here that you have to remove. A lot of people forget about those, so always make sure you have all the hardware out before you remove this. So as you can see here, we went ahead, we removed all the 8 millimeter bolts that are going around the valve cover so we can remove it. There's just one other thing on this particular model that's holding it on. And if you look down here, you'll see it. It's a tube that's running to this valve assembly. So all we have to do, move this clamp down, and pull the hose out, and that'll make sure this can remove all the way out of the way and we can move on to the next step. All right, so now we have the valve cover out of the way and we have access to both the valves that we're going to be needing to adjust. At this point, the most important thing is to make sure that the engine's at top dead center. And what does that really mean? Well, that means that when we adjust both of these valves, there's no pressure on these springs and tappets, which will allow us to get the proper measurement. What we're essentially doing is placing the piston at the top of its travel to make sure, well, there should be a little bit of slack in there. If there's not, that's the reason we're actually going to be adjusting it. So in order to do so, it's a lot easier to turn this engine over if we remove the spark plug first. So in order to do that, grab a 3/8 wrench, a 5/8 spark plug socket, and I would always recommend the ones that have the rubber grommet that's actually built inside here. This way the spark plug does not fall out, because that's the last thing you want, is for it to fall down into the shroud area. But in order to do that, what we're going to do, pull the spark plug boot off, grab your socket, place it on the spark plug, and then we're going to slowly loosen it. All right, so with the spark plug removed, it's going to be a lot easier to turn this engine over, which is going to be the next step. Now, I do want to show you over here on the camshaft itself. As I'm turning over the engine, the goal is to have these two holes that you'll see actually be aligned with the cylinder head itself. There'll be one over here and one over on the other side. We'll actually move the camera and show you a little bit better shot of that once we achieve that, but we're gonna move over here for now onto the side of the engine with the stator. And using a 12 millimeter socket on an extension, you'll be able to actually turn this engine over using that fan pulley. Just make sure you're all the way on there. And in a clockwise fashion, which would be tightened in this case, you're just gonna rotate the engine over until you get it to the proper position. All right, so we've rotated the engine over just to the point where you can see this large hole here on the camshaft is pointing directly away from the cylinder head. And the two smaller holes, I know it's kind of tough to see, but the two smaller holes down here are parallel with the cylinder head. And what this means, the engine is now at top dead center, so we're going to be able to get the most accurate adjustment possible on it. All right, so with the engine at top dead center, we're going to go ahead and check the clearance on the intake valve first. In order to do so, we're going to use these feeler gauges. I always recommend having both the 3000s and the 4000s feeler gauge. This way you can really dial in and make sure it's going to be adjusted properly. So what we're going to do, using the 3000s first, we're going to attempt to slide it underneath the tappet and see if there's enough clearance. And as you can see here, it actually does. We're going to check with the 4000s just to see if that will fit, and it will not. We always recommend at Bintelli 3 to 4 thousandths on the intake and 3 to 4 thousandths on the exhaust. And I know there's a lot of people out there who are wondering, why don't you say 3 or 4 thousandths? Well, every engine runs a little bit different. And what we found over the years is anywhere between those measurements is usually right where you want to be. And a lot of times what you'll find when you're adjusting these valves The exhaust is actually going to be tight, and maybe the intake isn't so much. And there's actually a reason for that. Most often, when you're running these engines as hard as everybody does, there's so much heat on the exhaust valve, it causes the metal to expand a lot quicker than, say, on the intake side. When metal expands, what happens? You lose your clearances. And as it just breaks in over time, normally, you'll find that exhaust is the first one that has to be adjusted. So what we're gonna do now, we'll take the 3000s, and we're gonna slide that in and check for clearance. And as you can see there, the 3000s goes in. There's a little bit of a drag on it, so it's probably set correctly, but we're gonna go ahead and take the 4000s anyways, and we'll see if we can get that one in as well. And as you can see, the 4000s will not go in. So this is a little bit on the tight side. We'll go ahead and we'll adjust that in the next step for you guys to see. All right, so in order to adjust the valves, what we're gonna have to do is loosen this lock nut that's sitting on top of the tappet. And in order to do that, you're gonna need a 9mm socket. I recommend using the 9mm socket on the 1/4-inch wrench. It gives you enough leverage to get in there and really be able to crack that loose without having to worry about scraping up your knuckles or anything like that. So what we'll do is we'll place that on the tappet. We'll crack it loose, like so. And that should be able to move with just your fingers now at this point. That's where you want to be. So with the tappet loose, we're now going to have to adjust for proper clearance. And this is a tricky spot where a lot of people use different types of tools, but I'm going to show you what I recommend. This pair of pliers is really, really small and allows you to grasp onto the end of the tappet and hold it in place. So during the next step, which is kind of tricky, you can actually see I'm able to hold it exactly where I want it. I can get the clearance dialed in exactly where I want, which in this case, we're gonna set this to 4/1000 of an inch and be able to adjust it properly. Okay, so right now I have the 4000s underneath the tappet, like you can see. I'm actually moving it back and forth. And by hand, what I'm gonna do is slowly adjust the tappet to the point where it's not too tight, but it's snug enough where it's almost hard enough to move the feeler gauge out of the way. It's almost pinching it, but not quite. I know that's a horrible explanation, but it's one of those things where if you do it a couple times, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. I know some people refer to it as a magnetic drag, and that's a very similar feeling if you've ever messed around with magnets before. But when in doubt, set it to 4/1000 of an inch, pull your feeler gauges out, tighten everything down, go back and recheck it. That's really the most important part about a valve adjustment, is going back, making sure it's set correctly, and doing it right the first time. So now, holding the tappet with my small pair of pliers and using my 4000s feeler gauge, I'm going to insert it just under the tappet, which can be a little tricky, especially on that exhaust side, so make sure you're actually all the way in there and it's underneath the tappet. And I'm going to slowly rotate it until it gets tight. Once it gets tight enough to the point where I feel it's the proper setting, I'm going to stop, remove my feeler gauge, and using a 9mm wrench, I'm going to tighten down that lock nut that we loosened earlier. And I'm going to do so very, very carefully because I don't want to move the tappet from the position that it was in. Make sure it's nice and snug, and then we'll check our tolerances. So now what we've done, we've actually tightened down the lock nut that's on top of the tappet. It's very, very secure. We always want to make sure that's clamped down properly. If that's ever too loose, you could actually run into some major issues with your valve train. So I would always recommend going back and double checking the tightness on both those lock nuts. It's very, very important. So what we'll do now, we'll take our 4000s feeler gauge, we're gonna slide it under that tappet just to double check one more time, and it's perfect. Now on this particular motor, the intake was 3000s, which is perfect, exactly what we wanted, and we went ahead and adjusted the exhaust to 4000s. And as I said earlier, it's usually a good idea to run a little bit looser on the exhaust side because inherently, the design of the engine, the way things work, that will slowly tighten up over time. So if you needed to adjust the intake, you would do so now, but on this one, it's good to go. All right, so now we have both the intake and the exhaust side of the valves adjusted properly. Now we're gonna go ahead and essentially put everything back together the way it was. And I do wanna mention at this point, since we already have the spark plug out, go ahead and take a look at it and see how it's been burning. There's a lot of stuff online. You can actually pull up all sorts of different charts showing you the burn on spark plugs. What does it mean? A good rule of thumb is you want to see a nice chocolate burn, exactly what we're seeing on this one. I don't know if you can get up close enough to actually notice that. I'm getting the thumbs up that you can. So that's a good sign. If the spark plug was actually worn down or if there was any type of a discoloration, we'd go ahead and we would change that now because essentially we're in the middle of servicing it. Do it right the first time. So after checking our spark plug, we went ahead, we reattached the spark plug boot. Make sure that's pressed down firmly. That should not be loose at all. There's actually a spring mechanism in there that grabs onto that tip of the spark plug. You want to make sure that's very firm and in place. So we're going to take the valve cover, which we removed. And on this particular model, it has that tube on there. We want to make sure we put that back, which is what we're going to do now. All right, so to finish up installing the valve cover, we're going to put all the hardware back that we took out originally. I do want to mention one quick tip. On this particular unit, you'll see that the emissions equipment has this small tube that goes to the bottom of the cylinder head. This pipe is by far the trickiest part to put on, so I always recommend getting that hardware started first. And that's actually the smaller of the two for the hardware. There should only be two of these. And as you can see right now, I just started these both by hand, and I have them just in there, just enough to get caught. And you'll see the valve cover is not attached. Both of this hardware started, and this is going to allow us to install the rest of the hardware much, much easier. So now we're just going to go around, put the rest of the hardware in, and tighten everything down just snug. All right, so now all the hardware is snug with the valve cover. At this point, using the quarter inch ratchet with the extension and the 8mm socket, we're just going to go around, and we're going to make sure all of those are nice and tight. Good to go. And there you have it. We wrapped up the valve adjustment on this 49cc Sprint. It's all set and ready to go. My name's Jason. On behalf of Bintelli Scooters, I welcome you to take a look at our website, bintellischooters.com. We have a dealer app on there that you can actually use to locate somebody close by to you if you're interested in getting any one of our models for 49 or 150cc scooters. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us via the website or leave a comment on this video below. Thanks. Have a great day.